So there's been a lot of buzz about Luminar AI. Is it all hype, or is there actually some merit to artificial intelligence with photo editing? Well, let's take a look right now. So here we are within Luminar AI. I already have an image imported. So the first thing I want to point out about Luminar AI is the workflow. Now the intention is to make things easier. So what they recommend is that you use the template as a starting point and then tweak it as you go. Now, you can always start from scratch and develop your own look and perhaps save your own settings, your own templates to use for future images. For this quick overview and review, I'm only going to touch on some things. So one of the things I really like about what Luminar does is, and this is part of the AI part, is that whatever photo you import, it gives you a template suggestion. So for this particular photo, it's already suggesting me to use one of these templates under Easy Landscapes. Now, if I go to see all, I have four options here: Big City Lights, Sunsets, Overcast, and Easy Landscapes. And each of these templates have pre-made settings that you can try out. So I'm going to go ahead with their suggestion and open Easy Landscapes up. So I'm going to go ahead with clean light. I like that it just really brings out some of the details here. And assuming you're happy with the template, now you would go under your edit tab here, and then on the right you'll see the menu. And under Essentials, you have all these different features that we'll talk about in a second. Then we have this palette here, which is Creative. This is where you could do sky replacement and change the mood, add some glow, things like that. The third one is for portraits. You have your face, skin and body AI, and high key in terms of lighting. And then you have your Pro tab for things like optics, contrast, color, and so on. So as I said before, I'm not going to touch on every little feature here, but I'm going to touch on some main ones that really make this program unique. Now, the first one is Enhance AI. Now, when I chose the template, it already had these settings, so if I were to take this off, you see that's a lot more flatter, has a bit less contrast, but when I click it back on, it's adjusted it accordingly. Now I could increase this to just highlight those blues more, get that contrast up a little bit more, and then it's got the sky enhancer where it really makes things just bolder and pop out more. But I kind of like the default features. I think it was about here. I'm gonna leave it at that. And the same thing goes for the structure AI. You know, it pulls out more detail. You can lessen the detail to get a softer look, that type of thing. And of course the color, you could increase the saturation, the vibrance. Very typical functions that most editors have. I'm going to go to the creative side here, and this is what I really want to show you, the sky replacement feature. The way sky replacement works is basically you take your image and you choose one of these options and it will automatically replace the sky for you. Now if I wanted dramatic skies, I could do that. Dramatic sunsets, I could do that. So I'm gonna just go back to, where was it? Blue sky, I think it was 5. There you go. So really love this feature. Augmented sky, this is where you could, you know, put in different objects. If you wanted a giraffe in there, even a moon. This is where I think it's falls more under digital manipulation. So I wouldn't really use this too much. You know, I can add some mountains, that type of thing. But hey, whatever floats your boat. You know, I like this rainbow feature. That's really cool. I want to head over to portrait now and show you some of the portrait features. So first we're going to look at the face features. The first one is face light. Now, if you have an image where the face is slightly underexposed, this is where you could really brighten the face up a little bit. As you see, I bring that all the way up. It really brightens that face up, but it does it in a way where it's not, you know, it's not overbearing. So I would probably bring this up just a little bit. It also has a slim face feature. You know, if you wanted to do that, I particularly wouldn't do this for this particular photo, which I find very handy. Then we have the eyes option. Again, this is where the AI really kicks in. Like if you wanted to change her eyes to blue or brown, that type of deal. So as you can see, it's pretty intense. Now, if you bring the visibility down, it brings it down just a notch there. I will make her original iris kind of pop a little bit. It's very subtle. And then you have iris flare. Now you're gonna see the catch light. So underneath kind of start to show some glow there, you know, some reflection just to make the eyes pop a bit. You can make the eyes bigger too, which I won't do at the moment. So maybe I want to whiten the eyes a bit here. Now, if I bring it all the way up, bring it back down, you see how that works very well, actually. And then the eye enhancer really just kind of gives a bit more detail in the eyes, gives it a bit more pop. And then you have all these other functions. If I switch to the mouth here, and this has mostly to do with the saturation of the lips. Like if I brought this all the way up, you see that it saturates the lips. It makes it just a bit more red here. And of course I can whiten the teeth, even though there's just a little bit showing. If I do a before and after, the shortcut key is backslash on the keyboard. Look how much the eyes pop out, how much the mouth, how much the lips pop out more. The face is a bit brighter. Now the skin thing is very handy too. In terms of smoothening the skin out, she already has really great natural skin here, and her makeup was done very well. Very simple, but very well. If I were to slide this all the way up, you see that it smoothens the skin out. It's a little much. I might do it at about halfway, and even there, it looks just a bit too fake. So I don't really even have to use this for this picture. I might use a little bit. And if there was any shine on her face, I could use the shine removal. If you see slightly, there's a bit of shine. If I bring that out, bring that all the way up, it disappears. So that's pretty handy too. So what I want to do here, show you quickly, is I'm going to bring all this stuff down here and really zoom in here. So there's a few defects here on Kat's face. Very pretty girl. Very little I have to do to this photo. I did change her eyes to brown. Actually, I meant to bring the tone down a bit there. There you go. And then I'm going to go to her skin. Now they have this thing called the skin defects removal. It works pretty decently, but if you really zoom in there, you can see it kind of just, you know, blurs it out and it doesn't look very natural. So I'm not sure if I would use this at all. I'd rather use the clone and stamp feature here. If they really wanted to go AI, they should have something like the healing brush in Photoshop or Pixlr. That's a very common feature. in many programs like this. So how I would do this is just the traditional clone and stamp way, where it keeps the texture of the skin. So that works much better in my opinion. So one other feature I wanted to touch on here really quickly is the erase tool. And I'm actually quite impressed on how great it works. It does a relatively clean job. But the first thing I did with this image was to delete this branch from the image. So what you want to do is go to Essentials, Erase, and you want to use a brush that's just the size of the object you're removing. When I come back here and click on Erase, just takes a few seconds and that stick is gone. Now that's all fine and dandy because the background was clear, but what about these branches? So let's try this out. Now this photo is not the highest quality. Unfortunately, I can no longer find the original RAW file. I only have old TIFF files left of this, so it's a bit pixelated when you zoom up close, but otherwise it still makes a great image. And for the most part, I'm pretty happy with that. You know, I can actually further delete this. That is a much nicer image for sure. So let's quickly talk about price. Now for two seats, meaning you can use it on two devices, it costs 139 Canadian for me because I'm in Canada, or for one seat, it's 108. And this is just the program itself. And you will only get, you know, the default templates. Of course, you can buy the additional membership that gives you more templates and even courses and other assets that may be beneficial to you. So who is Luminar AI for? In my opinion, if you're new to photo editing, Luminar makes the editing process very easy and very seamless. Now I can say the same for professional photographers that are really tight on time. And typically, professionals want to make their edits as quick as possible, but not sacrificing the quality. And I do believe this program can do that. Now, a program like this, with all the features available, of course, you want to use some of the things sparingly. Really, the goal is to touch up your photos, touch up your edits, and still look realistic. Now there's the other side of this where if you're a digital manipulator, there's so much more you can do with this program to give it that surreal fantasy look. But I still think programs like Photoshop are irreplaceable. There's so much you can do with it. Now if you're a Photoshop user, this would make a great plugin. Now would I recommend this program? I would say yes, with some reservations. Initially, it still feels like that they're trying to iron out all the little bugs. It still feels like it needs to be optimized in terms of, you know, being able to use this program on different devices, you know, laptops, desktops, Mac, PC, along with the fact that they're still to release AI bokeh and the reflection feature. That's said to be released in early 2021, but I think once these two features come out, it'll make the program even more beneficial for your photo editing needs. But I am very optimistic of what I see so far, and I look forward to seeing how they're gonna push the boundaries of this program. Now be sure to stick around for future videos as I'm going to cover more of what we talked about today. So make sure to hit that subscribe button and that notification bell to know when those videos will go live.